Hey everyone, welcome to the 10th episode of the BioTerminal Classroom. So in this episode, I will teach you how to use the built-in accelerometer and the light sensor on the BioTerminal. So now, let's get started. So now let's look at what we are going to learn today in this episode. So I will be mainly talking about the built-in accelerometer and the light sensor on the BioTerminal. So I will briefly talk about accelerometers and the types of accelerometers, and finally I will show you the accelerometer which is on the BioTerminal and give you a demonstration of using the accelerometer on the BioTerminal. Also, I will briefly explain about light sensors and show you how to use the built-in light sensor on the BioTerminal to make a simple demonstration. So now let's talk about accelerometers. So what is an accelerometer? So an accelerometer is an electromechanical device that can measure acceleration forces. So these acceleration forces can be static forces that remain constant, such as gravity, and dynamic forces that are caused by moving or vibrating the accelerometer. So how can we measure this acceleration? So normally accelerometers can measure acceleration on 1, 2, or 3 axes at the same time. So it can measure X, Y, or Z, or 2 axes at the same time, or else all 3 X, Y, Z axes at the same time. So you measure acceleration in meters per second square or in G forces. So when denoting acceleration in G forces, you need to write it as G. So every accelerometer has different measuring ranges, and this measuring range is denoted by the G force. So when the measuring range is smaller, the accelerometer is more sensitive. So in this case, the 10G accelerometer is much more sensitive than the 100G accelerometer. Accelerometers are widely used in wearables, mobile phones, laptops, and game controllers. So there are two main types of accelerometers. They are analog accelerometers and digital accelerometers. So analog accelerometers normally have a continuous voltage output which is proportional to the acceleration. So normally this voltage output has values between the ground and supply voltage. So when using analog accelerometers with microcontrollers such as Arduino, the onboard ADC on the microcontroller is used to convert the analog signals from the accelerometer to digital signals. So if you want to obtain different ADC for the accelerometer, you can easily change the MCU. There's one drawback to this type of accelerometers, and that is they are more susceptible to noise. So we offer various different accelerometers in the Grove family, and this is the Grove 3-axis analog accelerometer, and it is based on the ADXL356C chip. So I will show you later about how to choose the right accelerometer for your project. So now let's move on to talking about digital accelerometers. So digital accelerometers output square waves using pulse width modulation. So in digital accelerometers, the ADC is built onto the accelerometer itself. So you don't have to rely on the ADC of the microcontroller that you connect this to. However, when using this kind of digital accelerometer, you are limited to the ADC which is on the accelerometer. So even though you change the microcontroller, you cannot change the ADC because the ADC is on the accelerometer. Also, these kind of digital accelerometers are much less susceptible to noise. So this is a Grove 3-axis digital accelerometer which is based on the LIS3 DHTR sensor. So to learn more about the accelerometers that we offer in the Grove family, you can visit the accelerometer selection guide here, and then you can refer to this document and learn more about accelerometers. And also, if you go down, you can see there's a table where you can choose your accelerometer according to the project that you want to build. So you can see different parameters here, and each and every parameter is carefully arranged in this table to show you how each and every accelerometer differs from each other. So I will give a link to this URL in the video description so that you can visit this page and choose your own accelerometer. So now let's talk about the accelerometer which is used on the VIO terminal. So there is an inbuilt accelerometer on the VIO terminal, which is the 3-axis digital accelerometer based on the LIS3 DHTR sensor. So here, if you look closely at this diagram, you can see that the accelerometer is located here at the back of the VIO terminal. Also, these are some specifications of the accelerometer that is used here. So if you want to use this accelerometer in your project, you need to know how to define this accelerometer pin. So this accelerometer pin definitions can be found at variant.h file. So I have explained to you before in my previous videos that all the sensors that are connected to the VIO terminal have pin definitions which are defined at variant.h file. So now let's go to that file first. So this is the variant.h file. You can go to this directory and find the variant.h file, or you can search here on the search bar and open this file. So here, if you search for LIS3, this accelerometer, it's connected internally via the I2C interface. So let's go ahead and test this accelerometer. So first we need to install the LIS3 DHTR accelerometer library. So let's go ahead and download this library first. So I will give a link to this URL in the video description, and then download it as a zip file. After that, open Arduino and then go to sketch, include library and add .zip library, and point to the location where you have downloaded the library. So this is the location, and open it. And now you have successfully installed the accelerometer library. So now let's start writing our codes. So first let's include the library, the accelerometer library. So LIS3DHTR.h, and then let's initialize that library, LIS3DHTR. So two wire list. After that, let's move on to the setup. So inside the setup, let's start the serial communication. So serial.begin and set the baud rate to 115200. After that, let's start the accelerometer communication. So list.begin wire 1. Then let's write this loop. So if list serial.println error, while 1. So what this will do is, so this will check whether the accelerometer inside the VIO terminal is working or not. So now let's initialize the accelerometer settings. So list dot set output data rate, and then list 3DHTR data rate, and let's set it as 25 hertz. So I will comment here. So the data output rate can have values between 1 hertz up to 5 kilohertz. So here I have set it as 25 hertz, so you can change it into a value between 1 hertz and 5 kilohertz. Now let's set the accelerator measuring range. So list dot set full scale range, and list 3DHTR range, and I will set it to 2 G's. So this is the measuring range I have showed you before. The accelerometer inside the VIO terminal has a measuring range of 2G, 4G, 8G and 16G. So you can select any of these measuring ranges in this code. So I will comment it here, scale range 2G up to 16G. Next, let's move on to our loop. So inside the loop, it's at the float data type and write x values, y values, and z values. So we are going to store the accelerometer data, the x, y, and z accelerometer data onto these variables. So for x values, so this is the acceleration in x axis. So write it as list.getAcceleration x. And for y values, so that's the y axis acceleration. Let's do the same, acceleration y. Let's repeat it for z. So now let's write the codes to display the x, y, z axis accelerations inside the serial monitor. So serial.print x, then serial.print x values. So this one, this x values, it's the acceleration in x axis. Then let's do the same for the y axis acceleration. And finally, let's do for z axis acceleration. Then let's print a new line. Print ln. After that, let's add a delay of 50 milliseconds. Now let's upload this code to the board. So let's open the serial monitor here. And they set the board rate to 115200. Now let's move on to displaying the XYZ acceleration data on a line chart. So I have explained to you in my previous video how to draw line charts on the VIO terminal. And if you have missed that video, you can go to this playlist. I will give a link to this URL in the video description so that you can go and check the Classroom 5 video, which explains about how to draw line charts on the VIO terminal LCD screen. Or else you can also go to the line charts wiki page to know more about drawing line charts on the VIO terminal. So let's first download the line chart library. If you have already downloaded from my previous videos, you can skip these steps. So download it as a zip file and then open Arduino and go to sketch, include library and add.zip library and point to the location where you just downloaded. So this line chart library and install it to the Arduino IDE. After that, what I will do is I will go to the line chart wiki page and grab the example code from there. So here to this code, I will do some modifications so that we can display the acceleration data on the VIO terminal LCD screen. So here I'm not going to explain you about how to draw line charts because in my previous videos I've explained to you. And as I mentioned before, you can go and check those videos or the wiki page to know more about drawing line charts. So here what we'll do is we will add the library. We will include the accelerometer library. So list.thtr.h. Then we will initialize the accelerometer library. So list.thtr. Two wire and list. So I will keep this. This is the line chart library and this is the initialization of the TFT ESPi library. Here I have not included the TFT ESPi.h library because that library is already called inside the line chart.h library. After that, let's keep the maximum data size as 50 and change this storing data to doubles accelerator readings 3, and this is the buffer. And then let's move on to the setup. So So begin the TFT LCD display, setting the rotation, creating the buffer, and after this, let's begin the accelerometer communication. So this dot begin wire one, and then let's initialize the accelerometer settings as we have done before. This dot set output data rate. Data rate, set it to 25 hertz, and then list dot set full scale range, so that's the measuring range, list 3 DHTR, and let's set it to 2G. After that, let's move on to the loop. So inside the loop, we have specified to fill the screen in white color, and after that, let's initialize the variables to store the accelerometer data. So float x raw equals list dot get acceleration x, and repeat the same for y and z. After that, let's change this if loop here inside to accelerator readings 0 dot size, and let's get rid of this and type a for loop. So for u int 8, say I equals 0, I less than 3, I plus plus, accelerator readings I dot pop. So this is used to remove the first red variable from the accelerometer data. After that, to read the variables and store the data, let's delete this code first and type accelerator readings 0 dot push x raw. So this is to push the acceleration in x axis and store in accelerator readings, and continue to write for the y and z axis accelerations. After that, let's set the title for the graph. So here, let's change it to acceleration readings. So this is the alignment, center alignment, horizontal and vertically also center alignment, and change the thickness to 2. After that, set the line graph. So here we will change the starting point of y-axis to -2.0, and we will change this value accelerator readings 0 comma accelerator readings 1 comma accelerator readings 2. So this is passing the acceleration data, the XYZ acceleration data, into the line graph. So here, let's change the color. So let's set 3 colors for X, Y, and Z line graphs. So TFT blue for X, TFT red for Y, and TFT green for Z. Now let's upload this code to the board. Also, I want to mention that this accelerometer can be used to sense tapping motion, such as single tap or a double tap. So I will give a link to this URL in the video description so that you can go and visit this page and try this demo. So now let's move on to talking about light sensors. So what is a light sensor? So a light sensor is a photoelectric device that converts light energy to electrical energy. So this light energy consists of photons and the electrical energy consists of electrons. So how can we measure the light intensity? So when talking about light intensity, there are three units. They are candela, lumen, and lux. So candela refers to the luminous intensity. That is, it shows how strong the light is to the naked eye. And higher the luminous intensity means higher the sensitivity to our eyes. So lumen measures the total amount of light emitted in all directions. And lux represents the total amount of light that falls on a particular surface. So there are different types of light sensors such as photoresistors, photodiodes, and phototransistors. So this is the Grove light sensor version 1.2, and we offer many different kinds of light sensors in our Grove family. And if you go to this link, you can find a light sensor selection guide. And by referring to this selection guide, you can choose the light sensor that you want to use in your project. So the wire terminal also has a light sensor inbuilt. So if you look at the back of the wire terminal, you can see here, just above the micro SD card slot, there's a light sensor. And here you can find the specifications of the light sensor that we have used here. Also, if you want to use the light sensor with Arduino, you can check the light sensor pin definitions at variant.h and search for light sensor. You can find here that it's defined as VioLite. So you can use this pin name as VioLite in your Arduino code. So let's open Arduino and let's start writing our codes. So inside the setup, we will set the light sensor pin, so pin mode. So the pin name is VioLite and we will set it as an input. After that, let's begin the serial communication, serial.begin, and type the baud rate as 115200. Then inside the loop, let's define a variable as light and assign it to analog read VioLite. And let's serial.print light value. And serial.print ln, that's new line, and light. So that's going to read the light sensor analog values and display on the serial monitor. After that, let's set a delay of 200 milliseconds. Now let's upload this code to the board. So now I will show you a simple demo of using the light sensor on the wire terminal. So what we will do here is we will set the LCD screen of the wire terminal to turn on white color when the surrounding becomes dark. So first let's initialize the LCD screen. So hashtag include tftespi.h, and after that let's initialize that library tftespi.tft, and let's define the control pin of the LCD. So define hashtag define LCD backlight 72 UL. Keep in mind this U is uppercase and this L is lowercase. So this is the pin that the LCD backlight is connected to the wire terminal. After that, let's write our codes inside the setup. So let's set the pin mode and violi, and let's set it as an input. After that, let's begin the LCD screen, tft.begin, and let's turn off the LCD backlight. So digital write LCD backlight, set it to low. Now let's move on to the loop. So inside the loop, let's write a if loop. So if analog read violet is less than 200, digital write LCD backlight and set it to high. After that, fill the screen, tft.fillScreen, with white color, tft white. So what will happen is, when the analog value for the light sensor is less than 200, the backlight will turn on with white color. And if the analog value is more than 200, so let's write an else, type it, digital write LCD backlight, set it to low. So here, when the surrounding is dark, the LCD will turn on with white color, and when the surrounding is bright, the LCD will turn off. Now let's upload this code to the board. So that's it for this video. If you guys like this video, please give a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel to stay updated with us. So, see you guys in the next video.